Alhamdulillah that we're not alone and that Prophet is within us. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir Rahmanir Raheem. Malakut and the world of light is a completely different understanding than the world of form. Form stays separate, light doesn't stay separate. Light diffuses within each other. If you have a green light and a white light, it begins to merge within each other. And that reality that Prophet is, Allah is inspiring within us, is that light is within you. It's your responsibility to develop that light. Awliyaullah come into our lives to spark that light, to develop that light with the love of Prophet. And the fastest way is with Durood al-Sharif, to constantly praise upon Prophet so that you have the nazar and the reflection of Prophet upon your life. And then Allah describing that the benefit of that, the reality of that is that that light and that reality begin to teach you from Allah's revelations, begins to teach you from the Holy Kitab, begins to develop and to nourish you so that your light will grow and that you'll be prosperous with your soul, and begin to teach you from Divinely realities that which you knew not. And that is the goal that Allah wounds for us from this light that I have given into you of the love of Sayyidina Muhammad. And it's like a little flame, it requires a development so that that light will grow. That light will be the light of all mercy.
As-salamu alaykum, we hope you're enjoying the video inshaAllah. Just a request that you help us continue to make such amazing Islamic content inshaAllah. Share the video with your friends and loved ones, subscribe to the feeds, and donate, every bit helps. Jazakallah khair, we'll return to the program.
Alhamdulillah that we're not alone and that Prophet is within us. Allah said, "Fiikum." One fiikum is that you're developing that light by one of those guides. They want with their light to spark your heart, to bring your light of Sayyidina Muhammad, to develop your light of Sayyidina Muhammad, and all of us can testify that when we came in the proximity of these pious people, our light and our love for Prophet increased, exponentially increased. Our understanding and respect for Prophet increased, our understanding of Allah's holy kitab, Allah's holy uncreated Divinely words, all of those illuminations and lights and all of them increased, not by our cleverness but by their light in which they sparked within the heart of the believer. Awliyaullah and saintly souls carry the light of Sayyidina Muhammad on earth, and as a result your life in their proximity changes. Allah is teaching us to have consciousness and keep the company of pious people. Don't worry about which wali and what the rank of the wali, and I have a wali back in Pakistan and I have a wali there. I have, wherever you are lucky enough in life to meet one of these 124,000, it is the light of Sayyidina Muhammad. Means that's why we begin to understand why tariqs, the whole school is based on adab. That if you don't know your murshid, how are you going to know Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ? What, you're running to Medina to do what when you don't know the guide who you're with? The light that he's carrying, you don't see it, you don't recognize it, you're not respectful to it. All of that is within that guide that carry the light of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ, or Allah said, "Fiikum." It's in you that light. We are a selfish creature and we think about ourselves all the time, and every lecture is about ourselves, but they're teaching, no, no, the one who's sparking that light in you also from that understanding. The one who his soul and their souls are in the heart of Prophet ﷺ. The soul of awliya like a drop, the whole of creation is Muhammad Rasulullah. So then where are their souls located? If we call them ashiqeen, they must be in the heart of Prophet ﷺ. Their life and their arwah in this huge ocean, and they walk amongst you with their soul from that ocean. The light that they are carrying is from the light of Prophet ﷺ, because there's only one treasure from Allah. The treasure of Allah is only Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. Whatever ulum and knowledges and realities and karama and gifts and blessings any saint has, no matter which saint you love, it's from Prophet ﷺ. It's the Muhammadan light that manifests within them to their darajas. When that Muhammadan light is amongst you, don't worry about the different ranks and who your shaykh is, but love the one you're with. Love the one who's in front of you that carries that Muhammadan light. You will be held accountable to Allah and to His Rasul. And on a day when all the ego is destroyed and all the veils are brought down, and they describe for you that that light was in front of you, that whom you claim to love and that you profess to love and proudly went around carrying a banner saying you are carrying the sunnah of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ, then you feel ashamed. So that's why the turuqs come into our lives and teach everything is adab. Because you're dealing with a very precious light of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. And whatever you're doing, you're doing for the sake of Prophet ﷺ. Make your intention very clear that your bayah is to Allah, to fulfill Allah's ahad and covenant upon your soul. And the one who can complete that bayah is Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. So as a result, anywhere on earth you go, you take the hand of awliyaullah so that to reach Prophet ﷺ. And Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ is like the ocean, because all of them are like rivers, some faster, some smaller, but they all end up into the ocean, and that ocean is Prophet ﷺ. And Allah, its sahib and its owner, means that everything of that light is then our lives. So those who became successful in their tariqah life, in the way of Ahl Haqqaiq, they realized that that's the light of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ within my guide. And if I want to be true and I don't want to be a liar, and I definitely don't want to be a hypocrite. Don't claim to love Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ but you act differently to them. So then they come into our lives and they teach the schools of tarbiyah, teach you to love who you're with. Because even he's a small one, he's carrying the light of Prophet ﷺ. If he's a great one, he's carrying the light of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. Either way, you're going to be tested by the light of Prophet ﷺ. how you respond when that teaching comes. You're responding to the light of Sayyidina Muhammad. How you keep your tashreef and your respect, that's why you know it's a finishing school. Why they're so formal? Why do you keep all these manners? Why do you have all these rules? Have to be tests so that there can be grades. With grades there can be darajats. If there's no testing, there's no grades, there's no maqams, there's no darajats. That's why you have school, otherwise why don't we just make everybody a doctor? Then you'll have bad doctors and good doctors. It doesn't work that way for dunya, imagine then for akhirah.
With your generous support, we have helped many of the needy around the world. You can make a difference right now by helping us support those who need it the most. Give now at nurmuhammad.com/donate.
Allah, I want to give you a very big darajat. Do you really love Sayyidina Muhammad? And are those who are very sincere say, yes. And if you love and your love is sincere, you would have seen the Nur Muhammad in that guide. And in everything that guide does is filled from the light of Prophet. Whatever you're eating is from that light of knowledges, of realities that rizq and that coming upon your soul that ayah is describing, Allah's describing. It's through the fa'ikum, through that one who is appearing to you from the heart of Prophet. It means like a telescope, they are being sent out from the heart of Prophet to be amongst people. That what by that light of Sayyidina Muhammad, you are understanding Holy Qur'an because of their light. Each one is reflecting a Muhammadan light onto creation. 124,000 of these reflection towers upon earth for us to understand, and it's of no disrespect, it's like a cellular tower. So you have big towers and small towers. Small towers so that you lose no connectivity from wherever you're going. But there are towers that run an entire continent. There are towers that run just a city or a village. Means out of these 124,000 they are covering the earth. And now they're smartphones. You have all the nice buttons, all the nice gadgets. Everything in the zikr is being preparing and preparing the soul, preparing the characteristic for this signal to be sent. Nobody receiving direct signal from Allah other than shaitan's imagination. That's all shaitan wanted. So, I'm not following any of you guys, I take directly from Allah. He's incorrect and he was thrown out. Ati Allah wa ati Rasul. Means then Prophet is taking from Allah the Qudra. The Qul of Allah said, even I put it onto Mount Everest, it would be dust. But I send it upon your heart, the reality of Prophet takes that Qudra. But what Allah is going to ask you is that that Muhammadan light was amongst you. What did you do with it? Did you nourish it? Did you respect it? Did you love it? Did you constantly keep the company of it? For if you truly understood the light of it, you would have never left it alone. Because you feel the proximity of Prophet, you feel the love of Sayyidina Muhammad, you feel the emanations of Sayyidina Muhammad, and that becomes the spiritual path, that becomes the reality of what they're conveying to us, that that fi'ikum, one is your approach on how to nourish the light within your heart. But the one whom already been nourished, he's actually been dispersed and dispatched from the heart of Prophet to be with you. So Allah said, don't worry, you know, don't be anxious and concerned that I'm not able to go to Medina to the headquarters, but Medina is already with you, but what are you doing with it? And you're accountable for it. And wherever they go, people are being tested by it. That, oh, you are calling to be ashiqeen and you're reciting so many beautiful poetries, but yet there's a fi'ikum, there's maybe a Muhammadan nur amongst you of which you are not seeing it, and you're not hearing it, and you're not feeling it. You have eyes to see but yet you don't see, and you have ears to hear but you're not hearing. So then what's the benefit of all your practices? Means you're not reaching a point of sincerity where you're understanding that the pride has gone down and the bad character has gone down, and all that's left within the heart is love of Prophet. If that love was so sincere, as soon as they close their eyes they would have seen the image of Sayyidina Muhammad. There are children who see, not the adults. The children go back home and tell their parents, but I saw Prophet there, I saw Mawlana Shaykh there, I saw so and so there. Because they are mazloom, they're clean, they don't have, they're raised on zikr and nothing. But the parents don't, because the ego is blocking everything, hasad blocks everything. Means then for us is a reminder that fi'ikum is that light is amongst us. We're searching a life to find one of those lights and dedicate our life to that light, to the love of Prophet. Whatever you do to that light, it reaches. That's why we were teaching about one atom. If you are good to one atom of Prophet, it immediately notifies Sayyidina Muhammad. Not an action of love that Allah doesn't have a hisab for. Because this is only ashiqeen, these are not the people of amal. You do your amal because Allah ordered it. This is not where we're going to get our reward. This is only through love. Only through love can this be accomplished, and only through love can this exist, because they had such a love for Prophet that an atomic bond was created. So go back to your physics books, that only through love a bond was created. They released a negative charge and two elements came together. Only through love of Prophet you release the bad characteristic, Allah will take from your atomic reality and attach it to Prophet. If that one atom is attached to Prophet and Prophet begins to make a nazar upon that, begin to make salawat upon that, your light in a matter of a second will reach the stations in which is unimaginable and unachievable and has nothing to do with amal. But was the gift in which Allah gave to Prophet. So means He gives us that light, gives us that way, gives us that responsibility, that light is amongst you. Then what are you going to do with that light? How are you going to respect that light? How are you going to nourish that light? How are you going to develop yourself amongst that light?
Sheikh Nurjan's ever-growing online presence is the result of continuous financial input. And let us show you where your generous donations are going. We produce weekly television shows of Divinely Knowledge throughout Canada and the UK, as well as live stream internationally on Facebook and YouTube. Our Muhammadan Way app is continuously being upgraded and improved, providing an all-encompassing Islamic guide. In addition to the Muhammadan Way app, NurMuhammad.com is a website of immense knowledge and comprehensive Islamic teachings that is updated daily. Your ongoing support also enables a team of editors to compile books of heavenly wisdom from Sheikh Nurjan's teachings. One of our longest ongoing initiatives has been to provide basic necessities to the most in need worldwide, from feeding people in Vancouver's downtown east side, to clothing LA's homeless community, and supporting a children's orphanage in Pakistan. Your ongoing donations will help us continue to spread the love and example of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Become a shareholder in immense blessings. NurMuhammad.com/donate.